Sunday morning in England, we should be thinking about putting our feet up, maybe read the newspapers, a trip to church, or maybe possibly a game of golf, or walk the dog down by the river. All in all, it should be a total day of rest, but not here in Wolverhampton. If you're too hard for the army, or too tough for triathlons, maybe too macho for marathons, or I suppose if you just want to dive into freezing cold, and it is freezing cold water, then this Tough Guy race is right up your street.
The event began back in the 1980s as a simple cross-country run to raise money for charity. But over the years, obstacles were added that saw the route evolve into the wickedest assault course on the planet. It begins with a 6-mile run on farmland in the Staffordshire countryside before arriving for the last 2 miles at a section known as the Killing Field. This is where the competitors are taken to the limit of their endurance on a series of obstacles and challenges with names that strike dread into the heart of potential tough guys. Stalag Escape, the Viet Cong Tunnels, and the Tiger are just a few of them. 4,500 are here to brave the heights and take a January bath. For the last 22 years, the Tough Guy race has been here. Now, behind the race for all of those years is Billy Wilson, who... Billy, first and foremost, I need to know why. Why the Tough Guy race?
Why? Well, he said it, didn't he? Why climb Everest? Because it's there.
Let's do this, let's do this!
Come on!
Come on, I'll do it!
Oh my God!
We're taught to be tough, and I mean tough.
Is that a challenge that you're putting out there to any man, woman or child, that they should be able to do something like the Tough Guy race?
There is no such thing as impossibility. Everybody can achieve everything in their want in life. And it's your pinnacle, it's your aim, it's your taste of near death. We've had lots of people here come and tell me what I write, and it's true. You pass over and we bring you back. We take you to the extremes of your endurance. We take you out. What you will see tomorrow is horrors. Horrors of people in freezing cold, in barbed wire, in fire, everything we can throw at them to stop them.
I'm not doing the tough guy.
You said that with bated breath.
Well, I know, because a lot of my friends are always saying, oh, come on, yeah, Dawson, yeah. Get stuck into it, yeah, should have given it a go. Yeah. But I'm training for the triathlon, I'm taking it easy. However, I love obstacle courses. I'm not so fussed about the water. I've got my eye on the behemoth.
Yes.
And I just fancy having a... Can we have just a wander over and maybe can you talk through?
Yeah, yeah.
Would you mind doing that?
No problem.
Because it is enormous.
Enormous.
What is a behemoth, just out of interest?
Well, it was a name that cropped up at the time and it means something huge, ugly, horrible, something to fear.
This is the beginning of the behemoth. So maybe talk me through.
The real tough guys, you've got to get up those greasy poles. The granny's got the...
granny. So what you're trying to say is that if I am having a go at that bit, I've got to go up the poles.
Go up the pole.
Right, okay.
Up the pole.
Nobody calls Matt Dawson a granny. So it's the true tough guy route up the behemoth for me.
God, blimey. I don't fancy this much. And this is towards the end of the race. So people are going to be absolutely off their feet. I'm guessing there's going to be a few people on here at the same time. So as much as I can probably keep my balance. My arms, shoulders, My quad's really sore. This is, I've only just done one exercise, and then to finish it all, the thought of jumping into there straight away, freezing cold, it's going to be on fire, smoke everywhere. These guys are bonkers.
Now, it's not compulsory to do this race in fancy dress. You can do it undressed too.
Peter, I know you would guess, is from Scotland. He's just wearing a cheeky little thong. Any particular reason, Peter?
I like the cold.
One competitor is a veteran of the world's greatest adventures, like the Marathon des Sables and expeditions to the North Pole and even New Zealand's Mount Cook. But he could be about to find his greatest challenge here on the edge of Wolverhampton.
I'm freezing, which is not a good sign just before starting the race. You want to be nice and warm and toasty. I was saying earlier, if you were a doctor and wanted to design the perfect kind of course to get hypothermia, it would be this one. In and out of water and a fresh wind, fresh all the way in from eastern Siberia. I mean, it's about -5 today, so I'm properly scared.
These racers think they're ready, but they've got one last duty to perform. They have to sign the death warrant.
I confirm that if I should die on Tough Guy Route 2009, that it's my own bloody fault for coming. I understand that all safety measures are in place and that I should have my own personal insurance to cover my ineptitude. No claim may be made by me or my estate for loss of injury suffered by my self-inflicted failure. I know that the event doesn't have insurance and that no insurance company will cover this kind of activity. I enter at my own risk entirely and will not claim any damages whatsoever from the organisers.
Well, that's it. That's it. There's no turning back. He is now in the race. So let's get over to Rebecca Morris, who's going to speak to some of the tough guys and the girls who are ready for action.
You crazy man. Where have you come from today?
We come from Germany.
Have you done this before?
Second time. For me, it's the first time.
For him, it's
redneck. It's the first time for me.
Redneck.
I hear it's lovely. Nice course.
Yeah, we all ran it yesterday and I had a shock to the system and I'm dreading every moment of it.
Morning.
Hello. I don't quite know where to look. And to be honest, I'm not often lost for words, but how are you doing? You're looking nice.
Thank you very much. I'm feeling fresh today, yeah. It's a nice day for it. Quite brisk. I like it.
I did not know that SpongeBob SquarePants was a tough guy. Is he a tough guy?
He's the toughest. He's the toughest out there.
I think it's the coldest year as well so far. I've done this, so it'll be a challenge this year. I'm freezing my knuckles off here. Absolutely freezing.
With temperatures unlikely to rise above zero today and with the snow forecast, sensible tough guys and girls need to take precautions.
We've got Vaseline on, we've got deep heat, and we've got plastic gloves on everything.
Have you done it before?
No! Good job, because we didn't know what we let in ourselves before.
You're completely barbed.
I know.
No doubt these three representatives of the banking industry will have the best wishes of all. Is there like a bonus for getting through this with your briefcase, or is it going to get ditched?
There's going to be a beer inside it. So.
And the other main thing is it can be used as a flotation device.
Yeah. Or a slide as well.
Tough Guy is strangely attractive to Germans more than any other foreign nation. Every year, hundreds make the pilgrimage of pain to Wolverhampton. Why?
English people say tough guys are better lovers. The best lovers in the world, and so I do the tough guy race, you know?
This is a way of you proving that you are a good lover. I can think of other ways of proving that you are a good lover.
Are you a soft guy or a tough guy?
I'm always a tough guy, don't worry about that. A special German contingent, because this couple have just got married and they are celebrating by doing the tough guy. Gertz, what possessed you to woo your lovely wife on a honeymoon to Wolverhampton?
We didn't have enough money to go to the Bahamas.
Have you got a war cry? Have you got anything to psych yourselves up? Yeah. Give us that again, that was...
Adventurer Tarquin Cooper is looking nervous as they assemble at the start.
I'm pretty psyched for it now, actually. I'm looking forward to warming up. I'm just going to gun it down. It'll be awesome fun. I'm really looking
forward. How are your nipples?
I know you want to touch them.
Oh, well, you know,
maybe
later. Oh, chilly. I can feel it through my gloves.
Are you cold?
Are you cold? Do you know what? Only my toes.
Only moments to go to the start of the race on the coldest day in its 22-year history. Join me in a couple of minutes when the agony begins. Cold, cold.
It's the cold, the cold, the cold.
Welcome back to a sub-zero Wolverhampton, where 4,500 people want to take on the hardest assault course in the world. Why? Because they want to be tough guys. Let battle commence!
If you want to come out on top in Tough Guys, it's important to be on the front row for the start. A privileged position that has to be earned, and where you will find those elite tough guys looking for glory.
The people at the front are called front squad, and you earn the privilege to basically be in the front squad. To get to the front squad, you either have to have won the event previously as part of a team, and there are different team categories that you win. Previous tough guy who's organised, you know, large teams or raised an awful lot of money for the charity. So that's how you get it.
Price leads one such team from Dean Close School in Cheltenham, and they're so serious about preparation for the race that they even have their own training venue. Price is a teacher at the school and also leads Team Spy, a group of passionate Cornishmen with a tough guy addiction and some hardcore training methods.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
With moments to go until the start, it's almost time to see if those puddle press-ups will help bring in the silverware. And Ben's team are ready with the white crosses of war paint on their faces. But the competition will be intense, and the race favourite is Cambridge's James Appleton. He was second last year, but after some determined training, is the hot favourite to write his name in the annals of tough guy history.
How do you win something like this?
You switch off your brain. You just go. You can't think about it. You can't think about bodily injury or the cold or the fact that you're about to drop dead on tiredness. You just have to go. That's the only way to do it. Switch off your brain and just motor.
What's your favourite part of the course?
The hills, that's where they sort the men from the boys, in the hills. You find out who's got some grit and who's there for a laugh. That's where it's all decided, I think.
Has Appleton got the grit to win? How many of these people have got the grit to get back here in one piece? Time to find out.
It's worth being in the front squad because it's absolute carnage. It's like Braveheart at the start line. Everyone's really shouting and getting fired up and excited about the event, so it's a really good place to be. It's crazy. It's really, really good.
There are 6 miles of running before they return to the farm for the Killing Fields assault course. They need to keep something in reserve, but there are always a few over-enthusiastic charges at the start. Amongst them, Sam Ram, here enjoying his moment in the limelight. But it's nothing for the serious contenders like Appleton and Price to worry about, and our shot picks them up shoulder to shoulder here, Price with a black and white Cornish flag painted on his face.
In the past, I've made the mistake of going out too fast. I mean, the adrenaline takes over, and you go herring off down the hill and go along through the Killing Fields, you know, on the running section. And then you kind of think, crikey, I'm going far too quick because the adrenaline's just kind of taken over.
Appleton is taking it steady too and positioned just behind Price as they approach the first obstacle.
I kind of cruise down, not too slowly, not too fast, just steady, and then gradually kind of build up my pace, and then I just settled in about sort of fifth or sixth for the run. Try not to go too quick, but I was really pleased to find that I was up there.
This is obstacle number one. It's Chataway's Chase. It's not going to be the toughest, nothing compared to the rest of the course. It just gives them a taste of the pain.
What was echoing in my mind was, come on, just keep up with the lead pack and who knows, maybe you'll get a good time.
And as soon as we went in the water, that was replaced by a much more humble ambition, which was just to survive and get round in one piece.
There's a lesson for Appleton. After a mile, he's in first place, but the favourite will need to remember that if you're going to win this race, you have to survive it.
Yeah! That first bit just come all over the place already. Kills you. One jump, one obstacle, I'm knackered.
After 2 miles, it's looking easy for Appleton as he pulls out to a 30-second lead. Cheltenham's Ben Price is in fourth and not tempted to chase him down yet.
Can you catch him?
Got to leave a bit in the tank, haven't you? Come on, Team Spy. It's a parents' invitation.
All the time, the obstacles are getting harder and higher. The Tiger here is the first of the climbs with Appleton leading. Sam Ram and Graham Webb fighting for second, and then Price. A long way to go, and the experienced racers know the battle is yet to begin, while any rookies are in for a first surprise right here.
It's all right, Sean.
This obstacle is called the Tiger, which I reckon they're cruising it, but what they're not enjoying are the tiger's tails. These white strips, they've got an electric current going through them, and as you can hear, a little bit of pain, a little click, a little spark, all adds to the fun. There are some grown men crying as they go through the tiger's tail.
Literally jumped. I just went, whoa! And it was I was electrocuted. I mean, tell me a race in the world where they actually electrocute you. I mean, come on.
Don't kid yourself, there's no escape. It's the same lineup amongst the leaders, Appleton on course to do what everyone expects him to do, while Price is exceeding his own expectations.
I think I was fourth, and I was very, very happy with that. I kind of settled into a rhythm, and I thought, right, top five. I was aiming for top 30, and then I thought, right, top 10, I'll take that. So I kind of settled in there, sort of fourth or fifth. I thought, this is nice.
Nothing nice about the part of the course that Appleton himself predicted would sort the men out from the boys. After 4 miles, competitors reached the dreaded slalom hills. It's only a matter of a 50-metre hill climb. The snag is, though, you have to climb it 8 times as the route takes you up and down the slope.
And then we got to the bottom of the slaloms, and you just know that that's just pain. And actually, although it was a cold day, the sun came out onto our backs, so it was actually very hot for that section.
So it turns out some of the field did make the right fashion choice after all.
Woo! This one.
How are you feeling?
Oh.
Stupid question.
This stuff. Someone's throwing thing. Do you think you are? We've got a few left. And then this. Every time there's another hill to climb up. This hill.
You're doing really well, Tarquin. You're doing really well.
Thanks. I feel like I'm going to be sick.
But the thing about that slalom, and a lot of the obstacles here, that there's so many of them, it's not like jump through the water and carry on running, it's jump through the water and do it again, and again, and again, run up and down the hills, again, again, again.
You run as much as you can, then you have to just power walk most of the way because it's just too steep, and if you try and run up everything, then you're going to really struggle. You're really gasping for the final couple.
My legs are screaming, absolutely screaming.
It's a hard test for the heart and lungs, and a great section for the fit Appleton, who extends his lead to 2 minutes.
Walk in the park. Last one.
And then you turn round the final tree, run downhill, and it's a lovely feeling. So, yeah, it's tough, that bit.
Call that tough? Not compared to what's coming up. The sun will soon go behind the clouds, the snow and the temperature about to fall, and Appleton is about to get tied up in knots and frozen to a point where he seems unable to carry on as the chasing pack close in on the killing fields.
Oh,
Join us after the break when Tough Guy 2009 gets brutal. Welcome back to the Tough Guy 2009 here in the Staffordshire countryside near Wolverhampton. After 5 miles, race favourite James Appleton leads at the Gurkha Grand National, a series of nets and ditches that makes progress next to impossible at times. However, the 23-year-old has a 2-minute lead over his rivals.
You looking strong?
That's what training does.
Training as well as technique are important here. Appleton gets tangled up, as do the chasing pack, including Ben Price in the black and white face paint. His steady pace is paying off though, as he moves in to join the main group. This part of the course is where the competitors take their first steps in the freezing water they'll have to swim in later. But it's only up to their knees for now.
And the water, when you go in, I mean, it hurts. I mean, it's so cold, it really physically hurts your feet. It's like it's just a kind of clamp of pain.
Hey, Spidey, how you doing?
Hiya.
Web getting you through?
Yeah.
Use your superpowers and do all you can.
I don't want to peak too early. I'm saving it for the end.
Go back. Go, Spidey, go.
You're going in the water and out and in and out and in and out and in and out. And it was just, I mean, just soul destroying. Just sapped your energy and will to live, frankly.
In a few minutes, these people have to completely submerge themselves. James Appleton will be the first to face the horror.
Right.
Appleton arrives at the killing fields with an incredible 3-minute advantage. It seems impossible that anyone will catch him in the 2 miles before the finish. But remember, these won't be any ordinary 2 miles. Kevin Sutcliffe looks good in second. He's very strong.
We are coming to the business end of the Tough Guy, and to welcome them to the behemoth, the Sunshine.
Now, I tried this yesterday. It was tough, but I hadn't run 3, 4, 5 kilometres. I hadn't been over the tiger and through the tiger's tails. This is going to be a brutal task. It's wet, it's slippy, it's going to be cold on their hands. And to welcome them after they've done the behemoth, the Sob. Near miss for Sutcliffe as he leads Paul Jones and Ben Price onto the behemoth.
A bit dodgy going over that top A-frame because it's quite slippery and you have to go over the very top. And you look down and you think, crikey, this is a long way to fall. So I think people that suffer from vertigo might find that quite tough. Little moment of, oh, this is a bit sketch, but you kind of push through it.
There's no smoke without fire, and the next obstacle in the killing fields is known as the Battle of the Somme. 200 metres through flames, freezing pools, and thick mud. Third place Paul Jones doesn't even notice the blood as he charges towards the fire. As the masses arrive, the Battle of the Somme starts to really resemble a war zone.
It is the most exhausting thing I've ever done. This water is a killer.
My fingers are blue! They're bloody blue fingers! It's no good! I've got to get a walk!
I'm not cold!
Come on, Chef! Fill up water!
Come on, A-team!
I can't let a bunny rabbit run past me without saying hello. How are you?
Very cold.
What's your name?
Alice.
Alice. Right, now I would love to know what has possessed you to do this.
Well, my friend and I have done it for 2 years and we decided that we'd do it this year in something novelty.
So you haven't done it as a bunny before. Here comes another bunny. Now, where are you going? Bunny, you can't run away from me. I want to have a talk to the bunny. And it's nice and warm here.
It is warm.
I'm keeping you nice and warm. How's it been so far?
A bit gritty. The run was hard. Yeah. It was longer.
Was it?
Yeah, and the in and out of the troughs was... Worse
I bet
you've
had
wasn't
lots
it?
Of attention though in your we gorgeous
had
little
We've had a few helping hands.
Yes.
I bet you have. How's it been so far? All right, guys.
Horrible, cold, wet.
What's with the underwear?
There's no lager. Just pinched it from the missus's drop.
There's a sad state of affairs that you lot fit into your missus's clothes.
Size 8.
This is a Christmas present off our uncle as well.
Tell me that
Christmas
again.
Present off our uncle for this. This was. He paid for it for us for Christmas.
What sort of uncle does that? What's been the worst bit?
The hills. 950 metre hills. Absolute murder.
Is it killing you?
Absolute killer.
You've got the water tunnels to come. You know what they are?
No. First time.
Do you want me to tell you?
No. That's
it's
okay.
It's going to be cold. That's all I'm going to say. Get on that hay bale and get across.
Cheers, man.
Good lad. Good lad. Tell you what, these St John's Ambulance volunteers are rushed off their feet as casualties are tended to. Hypothermia is the biggest danger, but if hypothermia doesn't get you, claustrophobia might. Appleton leads in the Viet Cong tunnels.
That's nasty. I mean, it scratches you up pretty badly, that. You've got to be careful because I think some of them are blocked off, so you have to kind of peer in and see if you can see light at the end of the tunnel, and then you kind of wriggle your way through. I'm quite tall, so it's quite hard, so I have to kind of... There isn't really a technique for me, I just kind of get through as quick as I can. But I think Viet Cong tunnels is an obstacle that people do not like.
It's not going to beat me!
While the worst is yet to come for these poor souls, Appleton is about to meet it head on. It's the water tunnels. His lead has already been reduced on the first half of the killing fields, but Favourite needs to get through here quickly or he could be caught in the final mile. But when you duck your head under this water, as he's going to have to do soon, anything can happen. Here is our leader, and you can see the pain on his face. It's so cold, it's taken his breath away. He's managed to escape his head from being underneath, but no chance now. These are the water tunnels in the killing fields. He's gonna have to go under. What's it? Oh my goodness me, take a breath.
Come on, Jay.
Two to go. He doesn't know where to go, he's disorientated. Look at him, check him out. Packer closing in, and Appleton is still wobbling, hardly able to work out where he has to go next.
There are two submersion dunks, the telegraph poles across the top of the water, and then the raft where you have to go under, the proper underwater tunnels. I went under the first two. Kind of, you come up and you think, well, this is, you can't prepare for that. It's an amazing feeling. You've just got to get through as quickly as possible. And I think, I don't think the cold probably affected me as much as it affects others.
It's affecting the leader all right, and the chasing pack are cutting into his lead as Appleton takes on yet another strength-sapping vertical climb. It could all come down to who can cope best with the final few plunges in the ice-cold water. This isn't racing, it's survival. I think that is the definition of pain. I've never seen anyone so fearful of an obstacle in all my life.
Oh,
Ryan, how's it going? No! You are freezing cold. It's fairly safe to say that most of these guys would rather run around a rugby field getting their head kicked in by a load of forwards in a scrummage than duck their heads underneath the water four times at the water tunnel. It is brutal.
This is so cold.
Have you got what it takes to get through it all? Have you beaten it now that you've got through the water tunnels?
I'm not going to finish now. I haven't got this far to stop.
We haven't seen what could be the hardest part of the race yet, though. Coming up after the break, it's the finish. And a close race to be there first, as Appleton will need to find every single ounce of strength for a sprint to the line.
Home straight.
Welcome back to Tough Guy 2009. Now, there's just a few final obstacles to face for the leader, James Appleton, and he has good reason to look over his shoulder. As he faces the aptly titled Death Plunge, his rivals are closing in. Every time the course takes Appleton through the water, he loses seconds to the chasing pair of Paul Jones and Ben Price, whose pressure is relentless. Their intake of breath, they're absolutely shattered. But sometimes it's impossible to keep going in Tough Guy. By now, the snow is falling and the conditions are too much for some to bear. Just making progress around the course can be almost impossible, and the mud is so much worse for the tail enders.
Oh, no.
It's horrible. Bloody
cold. Final ropes obstacle is the Dragon Pool. It's a 50-metre rope crossing above what is also the last section of deep water. It's quicker to swim if you can stand the cold yet again, but by this stage, many competitors are just desperate to avoid any more water. Appleton loses more time to the chasing pack as he clings to the ropes all the way across. But Jones, Price and Sutcliffe go into the water, and they're quicker.
How are you feeling? Good. Now, got it in your sights. Home straight. Home straight.
Appleton's under real pressure at the final obstacle, a Stalag escape. 30 metres where you have to stay on your belly under barbed wire. The race favourite had a 3-minute lead at one point, but a cold day in the killing fields has really taken its toll. After this, there's a half-mile run to the finish. Price, Sutcliffe and Jones all have a chance of catching the leader if they have enough in the tank.
And I suddenly thought, I'm in second, and I had a lot more in my legs, actually, because I had to kind of settle for that position. And one of the guys said, go on, Cornwall. The first place guy's really struggling. So I thought, right, OK.
The chasing pack, and I tell you what, they are getting closer. They're narrowing the gap. It's neck and neck. And I think they're going to be cold, they're going to be sore, it's stony, the knees are going to be sore, they keep catching and ripping their backsides on this barbed wire, but they're away and they can see James Appleton. James Appleton is in their sights.
Well done, get on. So cold.
And you're just kind of going along. And it's fine if you're the only person on the rope. As soon as someone else comes in, you're like this. This is just get to the end, just get to the end, just get to the end. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Because I just really didn't want to go in the water that tub.
Did you say pleasure?
Sorry, I was hallucinating. Pain, agony, distress, that's more like it.
And you've got the barbed wire to come?
So much fun.
Can I let you into a secret?
Go for it.
I think you should go down the right-hand side. People are going through a lot quicker. I think it's a little bit deeper, therefore you don't have to be on your belly.
The pain is less profound.
But I'm trying to help you, seriously.
It's very kind, but I think I've got this right.
Has it been horrific?
Yes.
Nothing else going through your mind other than pain?
Agony, pain, cold. The whole thing's fun, it's just the cold.
How is it?
Jesus, I'm the most unwilling competitor ever. Don't ever let me do this again, it's freezing.
Fine, girl.
This way. So head down, right now. We'll keep your hand.
Well done, fella. Nice dress, by the way. Like it. Why don't you do a little bit underneath?
What is the last bit?
Oh, okay.
I'm here for more.
Oh, you're giving moral support? Your friend's doing it. Why don't you follow your friend? No, you're not. Come on. You're a tough guy.
It's too cold.
You're a tough guy. Oh, keep your head down. Keep your head down. Go on. Keep going, girl. Just 300 metres from the finish, James Appleton is hanging on as Ben Price closes in.
I could see James Appleton in the distance eventually, and I thought, God, he doesn't look too great. But I saw he was really struggling, and that gave me a real rush of adrenaline. And I thought, I could win Tough Guy here.
It's all nervous looks over his shoulder from Appleton now. Perhaps he knows he doesn't have enough strength for the sprint.
I wasn't aware of any pain I was in. I saw the guy who's in first, and adrenaline just kind of taken over, and I was really excited about the fact that I could win it. So I wasn't really aware of the pain. I was just pushing myself through and managed to catch up with him. And then in the last sort of 50 yards, 60 yards, I had a bit left in the tank and managed to sprint past it.
Barbara. You weren't running the edge of the water.
Which water?
You alright?
You alright, Dad?
You weren't running the edge. Right.
As the rest of the field come in, there are doubts over the result, Appleton believing that Price didn't complete the course properly. An inquiry is underway. Price could yet lose first place and Appleton be awarded the victory that had seemed to slide from his grasp.
When did you really start to feel the pain?
The underwater tunnels. Until then I felt brilliant. But the underwater tunnels is just horrible, man. It's death, it's horrible.
Worse than previous year?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Last year it wasn't as cold. And I went in some, I fell in one of the lakes and I couldn't really swim it, it was so cold. This year I managed to go over the ropes, so it wasn't so bad. But it's just, yeah, that was what I hit. And after that, it's horrible. It's death.
One of the most exciting Tough Guy stories ever has yet another twist to come. After an inquiry, Price is judged to have taken the wrong route on part of the course. His comeback doesn't count, while the win is awarded to Appleton. Performances of incredible mental and physical endurance from both of these tough guys, as well as every one of the 2,903 competitors, who make the finish to earn their freezing cold medal.
Hell.
Really?
Yeah.
What was the bit that really got you thinking, should I be doing this?
The tunnels.
I can't tell you how numb I feel. Pain.
The worst is the water, it's just the hands. My hands are in a lot of pain. It's tough, hardest one I've done yet, that. Fifth one, and it's the hardest one I've done yet. Can I go and get a cup of tea?
Good job, well done.
Got there eventually. Tough, very cold this year.
Glad I finished.
Well done, Matt. You must feel $1 million. The finish line. The finish line there.
It was nice, wasn't it?
Enjoyable, very much so.
Good way of spending a Sunday, would you recommend?
That's right, yeah. Wish it was colder.
You're a tough guy, that's what it is.
This isn't carry on tough guy, you know? What's going on?
At least the water was warm.
Yeah. Just another day at the office for you then.
I've got an interview in 10 minutes.
There she is, the last competitor to finish Tough Guy 2009. an epic day in a wintry Wolverhampton. They're all completely balmy. Goodbye from me.
That was fun.